And it's my honor to request you to kindly launch the skills platform.
Skilled manpower का एक बहुत बड़ा market पड़ा हुआ है. ऐसे market को tap करने की ताकत जिसके पास maximum youth है उसके पास है.
Thank you very much, sir, for launching this platform. May I now request you to kindly inaugurate the World Congress on IT and deliver the inaugural address. Sir.
Thank you. Union Minister of IT, Sri Ravi Shankar Prasad, Chief Minister, Governor of Telangana, Sri K. Chandrasekhar Rao, Chairman Nasscom, Secretary General Bitsa, other distinguished dignitaries, ladies and gentlemen, I am happy to inaugurate the World Congress on Information Technology. This event is being held in India for the first time. It has been organized in partnership with Nasscom, BITSA, and the government of Telangana. I'm sure it shall be of a mutual benefit to investors, innovators, think tanks and other stakeholders from across the world. I would have liked to be there in person. I'm happy, however, that the power of IT enables me to address you remotely. To all the delegates joining us from abroad, welcome to India. Welcome to Hyderabad. On the sidelines of this conference, I hope you shall have some time to explore the vibrant history and delectable cuisine of Hyderabad. I'm sure it shall encourage you to visit other parts of India as well. Indeed, India is home to ancient, rich and diverse cultures through which runs an underlying theme of unity. Ladies and gentlemen, the concept of Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam, the world is the family, is deeply imbibed in Indian philosophy. It reflects our inclusive traditions. In the 21st century, technology is becoming an enabler for this concept. It helps us create a seamless integrated world. a world where geographic distance no longer remains a barrier in collaborating for a better future. Today, India is the hotspot of digital innovation across all the sectors. We not only have a growing number of innovative entrepreneurs, but also a growing market for tech innovation. We were and we remain one of the most tech-friendly population in the world. With over 1 lakh villages linked with optical fiber, 121 crore mobile phones, 120 crore Aadhaar, and 50 crore internet users, India is best place to leverage the power of technology and leapfrog into the future. While ensuring empowerment of every citizen, Digital India is a journey bringing about digital inclusion for digital empowerment aided by digital infrastructure for digital delivery of services. Leveraging technology in such a holistic manner was unthinkable some years ago. We have successfully completed this life cycle in last 3.5 years. This has been possible through a change in public behavior and processes. Digital India has not remained merely a government initiative, but has become a way of life. Technology has transcended PowerPoint presentations and has become an inseparable part of people's life. While most government initiatives depend on a government push, Digital India is succeeding because of the people's pull. The Jam Trinity of combining 320 million Jandhan bank accounts of poor with Aadhaar and mobile with direct benefits of welfare measures has saved rupees 57,000 crores. Around 22 million digital hospital transactions across 172 hospitals in India are bringing comfort in the lives of patients. The National Scholarship Portal for Easy Scholarships today has 14 million students registered on it. E-Nam, an online agriculture market offering the best practices, best prices to the farmers, has 6.6 million farmers registered and 470 agriculture markets connected. Digital payments through BIM UPI has registered transactions of rupees 15,000 crore in January 2018. The unique Umang app, launched only 3 months back, is already offering 185 government services. Today, 2.8 lakh common service centers are there in different parts of the country, giving many digital services to people. About 10 lakh people work in these centers, including thousands of women entrepreneurs. In order to leverage the skills and talent of our youth, BPOs have started operating from places like Kohima and Imphal in Northeast India to areas of Jammu and Kashmir. 86 units across 27 states and union territories have already become operational, and many more are like to come up soon. To ensure digital literacy in every household, we have initiated a Pradhan Mantri Rural Digital Literacy Mission to make 60 million adults digitally literate in rural India. Under this, 10 million people have already been trained. We have come a long way with the convergence of Make in India and Digital India. From only 2 mobile manufacturing units, only 2 in India in 2014, today there are 118 units operational in India, including some of the best global brands. Government e-marketplace has been developed at the National Procurement Portal of India. It enables small and medium enterprises to compete in meeting the procurement requirement of the government. This simple IT framework has improved transparency in government procurement. It has also speeded up procurement processes and empowered thousands of small and medium enterprises. Yesterday, at Mumbai University, I had the opportunity to dedicate to the nation the Vadhvani Institute for Artificial Intelligence. This is an independent, non-profit research institute with a mission of artificial intelligence for social good. A few days ago, in Dubai, at the World Government Summit, I had the opportunity to visit an exhibition on the Museum of the Future. This has been planned as an incubator for idea and a driver for innovation. I appreciate the pioneers of technology, some of whom are in the audience today, for the work they are doing. They are helping to secure better, more comfortable future for humanity. We stand today at the cusp of the fourth industrial revolution. Technology, if used well for public good, can deliver lasting prosperity to mankind and sustainable future for our planet. It is in this context that I place the World Conference on Information Technology in India today. The key themes at this conference reflects the opportunities that await us. Disruptive technologies such as blockchain and the Internet of Things will have a deep impact in the way we live and work. They will require rapid adaptation in our workplaces. Skilling citizens for the workplace of the future is important. In India, we have launched the National Skill Development Mission to prepare our children and youth for a bright future. We also need to ensure that our existing workforce is able to reskill as new technologies emerge. One of the invited speakers at this event, the robot Sophia, shows the potential of new technologies. We need to reflect on the changing nature of jobs in the emerging age of intelligent automation. I compliment Nasscom for developing the Skills of the Future platform. I am told Nasscom has identified 8 important technologies. They include artificial intelligence, virtual reality, robotic process automation, Internet of Things, big data analytics, 3D printing, cloud computing, social and mobile. Nasscom has also identified 55 job roles that are going to be in high demand globally. I'm sure the Skills of Future platform will greatly help India maintain its competitive edge. Digital technology is now at the heart of every business. New technologies must be embedded in various operations and processes of a business entity. How can we prepare our millions of small and medium businesses for this transformation in a short time? Keeping in mind the importance of innovation in the future of economy and business, the Government of India has launched the Startup India Initiative. We believe our startups are the key to finding viable and economical solutions across sectors and verticals. Under the Atal Innovation Mission, we are building Atal Tinkering Labs in schools across India. The objective of this scheme is to foster curiosity, creativity, and imagination in young minds. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm sure that as you deliberate on various themes of information technology, you shall keep the interest of the common man at the back of your mind. I once again welcome the distinguished delegates from across the world to India. May your deliberations be productive. May the outcomes benefit the poor and the underprivileged across the world. Thank you very much.
Thank you.